that, Linda.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, I know.
Okay.
But now I muted us because it moves. How does she do this without doing that?
Good morning. Welcome to worship, and special welcome any visitors that are with us online or here. We are glad that you're here. We're excited. We have a baptism today. They're coming. They're just running a little late, so when you see them, we'll just all applaud when they come. No, we won't. Xander is being baptized today, which is Alex and Joni Brink's son. And Jennifer and Gary's grandson, and so we're looking forward to that. So look for that after the sermon. Makes you stay for the sermon that way, you know. All right. Just a note on COVID. We do encourage folks to mask now because of the Delta variant that's out, and it's just another level of protection. If you are social distanced, you're okay not to from those. But if you are not social distance, we do ask. It's kind of the 2 out of 3 rule that we're trying to play, either masked, social distance, and outside. So we got the outside covered, so now you need to either be masked or social distanced. Okay? All right. We will continue to kind of monitor this. We're still hoping to go inside on the 19th, but probably the week of is when we will make the final decision on that as we meet with the COVID response team and try to think that through. But in the meantime, we are glad that you are here, that you're outside enjoying this beautiful weather, or online in the safety of your home. And thanks for being part. Our reader today is Karen. Every once a month or so, we like Karen or someone online to read. So the online experience gets that as well. So we'll just hear the readings coming through the speaker today, if all goes as hoped and planned. All right. School supplies, we continue to collect. I just left the box inside this time because it's getting pretty full and heavy to move. So thank you for all who have donated. But please feel free to continue, and you can check your bulletin out to see those things that are needed. The open house that Katie and I were going to host next Sunday, we've postponed because of the Delta variant. And so we want to keep people protected, but we will reschedule that when it looks a little safer to do. So just know that, and we look forward to having you in our house. We did have a council retreat yesterday where we were able to sit outside for the most part and had good conversations and some good focus that was brought through that time together, and look forward to kind of letting you know what came out of that in the weeks and months to come. So I think finally, next Sunday is book group. Check your bulletin out to see what book is being read. I think they're meeting unless that changes. Frances always have that option, but currently planned for the patio at the Frances house. So, yeah, did you both know that, Paul? Did you know that? All right. Are there any other announcements for the good of the community? Seeing none, I invite you to stand for those who are here as we sing our opening hymn, Child of the Water.
You're a child of the water, child of the word, guided by promise and stories you've heard. God of the wounded knows you by name and carries you home every day. From your first breath to the last step, all of the dance. Down deep in your laughter, whatever your fears, try to remember. You're a child of the water, child of the word, guided by promise and stories you've heard. God of the wounded knows you by name and carries you home every day. Life is a gift, time carries on, and you will grow. Amidst your believing and throughout your doubt, something is sure. You're a child of the water, child of the word, guided by promise and stories you've heard. God of the wounded knows you by name and carries you home every day. We journey together as children of God, sealed by the cross. You're a child of the water, child of the word, guided by promise and stories you've heard. God of the wounded knows you by name and carries you home every day.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Together, let us pray. Holy God, your word feeds your people with life that is eternal. Direct our choices and preserve us in your truth, that renouncing what is false and evil, we may live in you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Got it.
Good morning. It's time for children's time. So if the children want to come up real quick, and anybody watching at home, come close to the camera. Come on up, kids. Oliver, Charlotte, Ruby, Julia, come on up. How are you this morning? Good, good to see you. Sandy's going to help us this morning. Is that okay? All right, well, today we're going to talk about the words that Jesus says. That's what we'll hear, a story about the words that Jesus speaks to us. And right before the story that we're going to hear today, Jesus fed 5,000 people with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. So we've got some fish and we've got some bread. Do you guys want to try some? This is challah bread, if it's okay with your mom and your dad. We've got some smoked fish. This is what Jesus used to feed 5,000 people. That's smoked salmon and some challah bread. There you go. Okay. And we'll have some more of this to pass out for anybody else who's interested. Smoked fish and bread, that's what Jesus used to feed us. And we're still eating fish and bread today. But something else that we can feed on is Jesus's words. And in a way, we take in his words and kind of chew on those and think about them. And Jesus said, the words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. And spirit is all the things inside of us, and life is all of this. So Jesus' words that he has spoken to us are spirit and life, because, the second one here, because Jesus said, we do not live by bread and fish, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. So we live on the words that comes from the mouth of God, and that's a good thing. So is bread and fish, but remember to listen to the words. So let's pray together, okay? Repeat after me, dear God, open our ears to hear, and our mouths to share your words that give eternal life. Amen. Okay, thanks for coming up and enjoy your bread and fish. And for anybody else, we've got a little bit of a snack here to pass around for anybody interested. And then we'll get to the real meal in a few minutes.
The first reading is from 1 Kings chapter 8. There we go. So the first reading is from 1 Kings chapter 8. Solomon assembled the elders of Israel and all the heads of the tribes and the leaders of the ancestral houses of the Israelites before King Solomon in Jerusalem to bring up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord out of the city of David, which is Zion. Then the priests brought the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord to its place in the inner sanctuary of the house, in the most holy place, underneath the wings of the cherubim. And when the priests came out of the holy place, a cloud filled the house of the Lord, so that the priests could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord. Then Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the assembly of Israel and spread out his hands to heaven. He said, O Lord God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven above or on earth beneath, keeping covenant and steadfast love for your servants who walk before you with all their heart. The covenant that you kept for your servant, my father David, as you declared to him, you promised with your mouth and have this day fulfilled with your hand. Therefore, O Lord, God of Israel, keep for your servant, my father David, that's what you promised him, saying, there shall never fail you a successor before me to sit on the throne of Israel, if only your children look to their way to walk before me as you have walked before me. Therefore, O God of Israel, let your word be confirmed, which you promised to your servant, my father David. But will God indeed dwell in the earth? Even heaven and the highest heavens cannot contain you, much less this house that I have built. Regard your servant's prayers and his plea, O Lord, my God, heeding the cry and the prayer that your servant prays to you today, that your eyes may be opened night and day towards this house, the place which you said, my name shall be there, that you may heal the prayer that your servant prays towards this place. Hear the plea of your servant and of your people Israel when they pray towards this place. O hear in heaven your dwelling place, heed and forgive. Likewise, when a foreigner who is not of your people Israel, comes from a distant land because of your name? For they shall hear of your great name, your mighty hand and your outstretched arm. When a foreigner comes and prays towards this house, then hear in heaven your dwelling place, and do according to all that the foreigner calls to you, so that all the people of the earth shall know your name and fear you, as do your people Israel, so that they may know that your name has been invoked on this house that I have built. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And if I should continue with the psalm, I will do so. Otherwise, I'll watch for someone to approach the speaker. So let's continue. The psalm today is from Psalm 34, verses 15 through 22, and we'll say together the refrain, "The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous." The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and God's ears are open to their cry. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them and deliver them from all their troubles. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous. Many are the troubles of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them from every one. Evil will bring death to the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be punished. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous. The second reading is from Ephesians chapter 6. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, and against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, stand firm. Stand, therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness as shoes for your feet. Put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times, in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always preserve in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, that when I speak, a message may be given to make known the boldness and the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chain. Pray that I may deliver it boldly, as I must speak. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me.
This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever. He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue of Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, and the flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you, there are some who do not believe, for Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. It was the third or maybe the fourth job that I ever had. It followed being a newspaper carrier, mowing a bunch of lawns, and then working at a Japanese steakhouse. I was hired to sell electronics for a store that sold a lot of refurbished goods and things on discounts. Now, if you knew about my knowledge with electronics, you would have found that to be extremely funny. John, in there, do not laugh at me too much. But the job that I had, each of those jobs, you learn something. And at this particular job, I learned a few things from the manager, and his name was Greg. He would walk along and ask us to follow him from time to time, and he would face an end cap and say, "It's a little thing, but a big thing." And as that face cap was ended, it would look better, and we could see what he's talking about. Or he would say, "Hey, I want you to go and greet that customer and welcome them to the store. It's a little thing, but it's a big thing." Customer service, it's a little thing, but a big thing. How the store looked, it's a little thing, but a big thing. At church, we give a little bit of bread and a sip of wine at communion. When we baptize Xander in just a little bit, we will give him a little splash of water, or a big splash, depending on what kind of mood I'm in. But it's a little thing, but it's a big thing. How can these little things sustain us with all that is going on in the world? It's been a difficult week if we read the news and look at things, hasn't it? Hundreds, if not thousands, dead in Haiti due to another earthquake that shook that fragile nation just 11 years after the last big earthquake. Not to mention the fact of how it's reeling from political strife. Afghanistan is seemingly blowing up once again as the U.S. learned that even with good intentions or bad intentions, there are no easy answers when you attempt to police the world. The word evil is getting thrown around more and more towards anyone who thinks differently. COVID cases have again filled our hospitals, and healthcare workers are at their physical limit. Oh, where should we turn to answers of these difficult questions? How do we protect ourselves? Well, Jesus could have been about protecting himself in our gospel for today. Where he's starting to see some of his followers leaving him. His teachings are difficult, especially that one that says, "Whoever eats me will live forever." The one who eats this bread and drinks this wine will live forever. And he goes on to say that these words are spirit and they're life. Following what Jesus has to say and what Jesus does, remember, it's a little thing, but it's a big thing. When people ask me what they should first read in the Bible, I will always tell them to start with the Gospels. Not because everything in the Gospel is always clear, but through those things, we get to know the story of Jesus. When teaching new member classes, I am quick to point out that Lutherans do not look at all of Scripture equally. Luther liked to say, that which points us to Jesus is of utmost importance. Part of the reason I think that red letter Bibles came to be, somehow what Jesus says is to capture our attention unlike anything else, even in Scripture. So to see what Jesus is about, we need to start with the Gospels. And then I say the Psalms, because the Psalms are the prayer book for Jesus. In the back of our minds, we should always have Peter's words. Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Peter says this when Jesus is seeing people flee all around him. The little thing of eating Jesus' flesh and drinking his blood has become a big thing. But Jesus literally wants us to put him on, to abide, to become as close to him as we possibly can. I think it's a reading from Ephesians that might be a little bit helpful in this situation. We don't talk a lot about spiritual warfare these days. It makes us uncomfortable, and that's what the other Christians do. But in a world that is obsessed with calling the other the devil or evil or Satan, if we can always look outside of us and say, that is what's wrong with the world, it may be even more important to think about what we are truly putting on these days. Paul uses a war metaphor about putting on armor. But the armor that Paul is talking about is really an image of putting on Jesus, of putting on Christ. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power, Paul starts out. What helps us with the big things of this world are not of God, that are not of God, is to stand with Jesus, putting on the breastplate of righteousness. Shoes that make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. A shield of faith. A helmet of salvation. And a spirit that is the sword. Which is, as Mark was talking to us about, the word of God. This is what it means to put on Christ. Our stories today in Scripture invite us to consider whether we have on the wrong armor. The tools that the New Testament implores believers to embrace, they're strange. In the face of all the spiritual forces that rebel against God, we arm people with a bit of bread, a small sip of wine that is somehow for us the body and blood of Jesus himself. It calls us to consider that perhaps we have been wearing the wrong armor, or at least the armor of the world, for so long that we don't even realize that it is the very thing that makes it impossible for us to put on the armor of Christ, the armor of faith. How many times are we wearing the armor of distrust, hatred, and violence that hangs over us and fills our hearts and makes it impossible for us to pick up the armor of truth, righteousness, peace, and the Spirit? In short, it's impossible to proclaim the love of Jesus with a sword in your hand. Today's lesson invites us to put down the armor of the world and put on the armor of light. Xander doesn't know it, but today he is putting on Jesus. That ultimately is what baptism is about. As Xander is sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever, he will put on a different sort of armor. It's a splash of water, a bit of bread, a sip of wine. It's a little thing, but it's also the biggest thing there is. It is the little things that unite us to Jesus. When things get overwhelming around us, when we have weeks like we've had this week, a little water, a bit of bread, and a sip of wine bring us together in a community that is in this journey for the long haul, because that's what eternal life is. Lord, to whom shall we go? It is Jesus. And Jesus' words that help us deal with the big things in life. They help us show us that it is not my righteousness, but our righteousness. It doesn't rest on my faith, but our faith. It isn't even about my spirit, but God's Spirit working through us as we attempt each week to stand with Jesus. Dare I say it? Put on Jesus. Because it is with Jesus and what Jesus teaches and Jesus' words that leads us on. Oh, it's a little thing, but it's the biggest thing of all. When all pulls you away from coming together on a Sunday morning, remember, a little bread, a sip of wine, a splash of water, and you are armed with all you need for true life. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Please join me in these. Hello? Ah, thank you. Please join me in hymn number 496, One Bread, One Body. Servant or free. and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body. Gifts, many the works, one in the Lord of all. One bread, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body.
And welcome to Xander and Xander's family that is here representing, and any who are online that might be joining us as well. We have, and you can come closer here, come right in front. Right now, the font is the center, and the altar takes second stage for just a little bit. So, Xander's about a year and a half, so if he starts running around a bit, we're fine with it. We'll just pick him up for the baptism section itself. All right. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. So I have a question for the sponsors. I'm asked, who presents Xander for baptism? So, called by the Holy Spirit and trusting in the grace and love of God, I ask the parents, do you desire to have Alexzander baptized into Christ? As you bring Xander to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with some responsibilities, just like we talked about when we gathered. To live with him among God's faithful people, to bring him to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach him the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, and to place in his hands the Holy Scriptures and nurture him in faith and prayer so that he may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, to care for others in the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. That's what it means to put on Jesus. That's right. And he's looking at you all going, yeah. Do you promise to help Xander grow in the Christian faith and life? All right. Sponsors, do you promise to nurture Alexzander in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help him live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? If so, say, I do. I do. And people of God out there, might be Xander, you don't know who's going to come across. It might be some of his teachers. It might be coaches. It might be grandparents. It might be a lot of people that sponsor him as well. So people of God, do so promise to support Alexzander and to pray for him in his new life in Christ.
We do.
All right. I ask you now to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin and confess the faith of the church, to renounce evil and all the forces that defy God. So would you please stand as a congregation? Do you promise to renounce evil and all the forces that defy God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
And do you renounce all the ways of sin that drive you from God?
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord,
who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. Let me get this off real quick.
Made children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of courage, bless all leaders of your church. Make them ready to proclaim the gospel of peace and strengthen them to preach your loving word. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of creation, bless fields and orchards. Protect the land from drought and bring life-giving rain to support growth. Instruct your people in wise treatment of the world that you have provided for all your creatures. And be with all of creation that is dealing with wildfires. Lord, in your mercy, God, our refuge and strength, you have bound us together in a common life. Be with the people of Haiti in the aftermath of the earthquake, where anxiety is infectious and widening. Grant peace and reassurance, where grief and pain overwhelm. Be the sure and certain hope that is so needed at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, you have the words of eternal life. Be with all in Afghanistan who are living in more uncertainty than before. Give wisdom to our government as we look to respond to the growing crisis. Open the hearts of the Taliban to new ways of seeing. And help us see where our pride gets in the way of responding in your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of compassion, bless all who are in any need. Especially, we pray this morning for the residents and staff at Good Samaritan Care Center. We pray for Eunice Care and her family on the death of her husband, Chuck. We pray for Bill Groppler, faced with health concerns. We also pray for Joanne Goldsvig, who is in hospice care. I pray for my mom. We also pray for the family of Mary Lou Westerland at the time of her death. Mary Lou is the mother of Nancy McChesney. For who else do the people of God pray? Pray for Mary. Pray for firefighters.
Pray for all the Asians who are suffering discrimination.
Pray for the Asian community suffering from discrimination and hate. We pray for those who suffer from chronic pain. For those in the northeast of the U.S. getting ready for the hurricane.
For all my patients, have triaged online.
For all of David's patients, triaged online.
For Courtney's friend Cheryl, hospitalized with COVID.
For Courtney's friend Cheryl, hospitalized with COVID.
And for Billy.
We pray for Billy. Lord, in your mercy, God of comfort, bless all who mourn the deaths of their beloved ones. We give you thanks for the saints who have gone before us. Renew our confidence in your promise of resurrection and life in the world to come. Lord, in your mercy, today we give thanks for these baptismal anniversaries that are this week. And those are for Kate Landon, Natalie and Everett Brandt, Anna Lee Gustafson, Jeff Kruger, and Bob and Michael Johnson, again celebrating baptismal anniversaries this week. For what else do the people of God give thanks? I give thanks for Sandy's birthday coming up Tuesday. Thanks for Sandy's memory of her friend Laura, whose birthday was will be Tuesday as well, the 24th. Thanks for the children of United, especially Alexander today. Thanks to the doctors and nurses and the care they give.
Thanks for our church council.
Thanks for the church council, working hard as always. We give thanks for first responders and military and all of their family.
For the life of Victor Steinhardt. Thank you for Brent, for the lovely music, and for all those who have received the vaccine.
Thank you to Brent for the lovely music and all who have received the vaccine. Thanks for the children in our lives. Lord, in your mercy. God of change, bless our transitions. Guide all who are embarking on new stages in life, such as a new job, new school, or a new community. Sustain enduring friendships and kindle new relationships and interests. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive these prayers, O God, and those who are in our hearts, known only to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we give thanks for Xander and his great energy that he has this morning. He has his own mind, as a good year and a half will. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit, and by the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live for you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life to you. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord in the unity of the Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. All right. Want to splash in it a little bit, Xander? And you, you all can come close. All right. Alexzander, Jonathan, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Xander, watch this. Remember to live wet. Live wet. All right. All right. Let us pray.
We give you thanks, O God, that through the water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth. Cleanse them from sin and raise them to eternal life.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Sustain Alexander Jonathan with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence both now and forever.
Amen.
Alexander Jonathan, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit, and I'm going to mark you with the cross of Christ forever, even if you don't like it. I anoint your hands that you may do God's work. I anoint your feet that you may walk humbly with your God. I anoint your eyes that you may see God's glory in the world. I anoint your ears. Where are your ears? That you may hear God's word clearly in your life. And may you always know you are a loved child of God. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, let's see if, yeah, it's still going, and I just dripped wax on myself. This is a gift from the congregation. I'm going to hand it to Mom. And we say to Xander, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. We ask that you light this candle, and as sponsors, to remind them to light this candle each time on the 22nd of August. Absolutely. All right. So, let us welcome this newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. Amen. Xander Brink, it's my privilege to introduce him as the newest member of the body of Christ. All right.
Yay!
All right. The peace of Jesus be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of that peace at a good social distance with one another. God's peace to all who are online, and thank you. And you can blow that out now. Yeah. Yeah.
Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the life of the world. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and
praise. It is indeed right and good that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection, opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join the unending hymn. Our Lord Jesus, in the night in which he is betrayed, took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for them all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As we commune this day, we will set up two stations right at the curb here. Know that all the wine today is red, and so the grape juice is in the uplifted center portion of the tray, and then around the outside is wine. Taste and see that the Lord is good, whether you are in person or at home. Know that Christ is present with us here. Amen. And with you there. Oops, I forgot to grab. Be right there. We'll be right with you. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the gifts of his body and blood, may they strengthen, keep, and unite us now and forever. Amen.
Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Just as a note, a special thanks for all who worked to put on this service. We had a lot of moving parts, and we even added another thing. So thanks for Brent for joining in with some live guitar, for Philip for all the incredible work you always do, Philip, for John for continuing to work through the different things, and for the many people that make worship happen here. It's fun to see, and it's always a good experience. So thank you to everyone. Receive the benediction. May our glorious God grant you the spirit of wisdom to know and love the risen Lord Christ, the God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Bless you now and forever. Amen. Now go in peace. You are the body of Christ.
Thanks be to God.